hug me and let me spin through the ground like a drill.
Thank you. Thank you. Death watch beetles rattling. casings rattle on the ground. I don't know. I don't know. The garret lock is rusted in the chamber. Blade of light that spills upon the ground. I don't know. I don't know. What am I saying? What am I saying? Element evoke an empty gestures. I don't know. I don't know. The chain links tattered, hanging like a slip knot. I don't. I don't know. Water tower, talisman, stillborn. I don't know. I
It was so quiet and peaceful and altogether lovely there in the green forest, where Lightfoot the deer lay resting behind a pile of brush near the top of a little hill, that it didn't seem possible such a thing as sudden death could be anywhere near. It didn't seem possible that there could be any need for watchfulness. But Lightfoot long ago had learned that often danger is nearest when it seems least to be expected. He kept his beautiful, great, soft eyes fixed in the direction from which the hunter with the terrible gun would come if he was still following that trail. He kept his great ears gently moving to catch every little sound. Lightfoot had about decided the hunter had given up hunting for that day, but he didn't let this keep him from being any the less watchful. It was better to be overwatchful than the least bit careless. By and by, Lightfoot's keen ears caught the sound of the snapping of a little stick in the distance. And a moment later, a man came into view. It was the hunter, and across one arm he carried the terrible gun. Lightfoot kept perfectly still and watched the hunter disappear among the trees. Then, he got to his feet, shook himself lightly, and noiselessly stole away over the hilltop towards another part of the green forest. He felt sure that that hunter would not find him again that day. End of chapter 11. Recording by Sharon Chimeridan.
The swoon. Thank you. I don't wanna be a part of this.
Brighton room, similar to this, a drinker smiles and cracks his lips and lets it all fade to grey. The wind blows cold through your hair. I'm in the squall again. If you battle on with wordless resolve, I am left waiting behind a door that I have closed. That I have